re shebile ba re galela ba re entse window shopping
ha re sense
Yo, escape people, Kamo Mphela here. Shout out to Sports Scene and Adidas and the Weekend Turn Up feature. I'm very happy to be on this. Hopefully, it's going to be very interesting. Guys, do stay tuned in because I'm very excited. You know what I'm saying. So, let's get to it. Kamo Mphela started off as a dancer and an MC, which later grew into this whole artist. So this is like a whole culture, like that place, that township has this culture thing going on, you know, where you just like Kimokas, you know, I'm the Kasi girl. Like you'll never change, like want to go to the burbs, rather take the hood and the classiness, put it into one and become your own person. So the hood actually is very influential for all the youth, you know. Like I'd always go to my mom. My mom used to stay in Mdeni. So I'd always go to her just to gravitate because the burbs got too boring, man. Well, I've always been confident. Like, it started in high school. I used to open circles in high school when it's like break. I used to be very rebellious. I won't say it's a good thing, but I just always had that confidence and I've always believed in being something bigger than just like a dancer or whatever. So at first, when I was in grade 10, I wanted to be like a pilot and everything, you know, when you're young and you don't really have a vision. And then I started doing MCing gigs from grade 11, doing free MCing gigs and everything, pushing just to see like what I really liked. Because at first I wanted to act and then I figured out I actually don't like doing something more than once. So I was actually like, okay, dancing, you're not gonna have to repeat something for more than twice, you know, which is like you give your best on your first shot. So I started dancing, opening circles in high school. Basically what happened was I started trending. I posted a promo video for my MC gig. So basically we were doing a promo edit myself and Sway, my best friend. We were doing a promo for Jobber's birthday party. And then we started some trend, Harry, you know, I can't say it, but Harry, what. And people were like, okay, these girls are cool, you know? And everyone was just like, oh, what's up with these girls? And then it grew into, okay, got to the Jobber party, got to the whole Jobber thing, the whole Jobber mix. And then JR and Rich Mahog actually pulled through to the party, which was really dope, you know? And then when they pulled through, Rich actually posted me on Twitter. I was like, yo, shout out to this girl, Kamo, she's a superstar, watch out for her. And obviously Twitter, Black Twitter, you know what Black Twitter is. Always going at people like, what's so special about this girl hyping people up at parties? And then he was like, nah, there's more to it, but I'm not gonna say anything. You guys are gonna tell me about this. And then it came to Miss Cosbo saying, I actually wanna book this girl. And I was like, actually, from rather waiting for MC gigs, let me actually post my own content, dancing. So I started doing gassy things, dancing by the robots, dancing on the streets, doing original gassy stuff that people are going to be drawn to, apart from me just dancing and looking normal that everybody does. You know, it's very risky when I dance estrateni and cars are moving around. Like, that's very original. And gassy people know that culture. So I was just like, yeah, that's what helped me. Kila Kao was under my previous management, Smia. So Smia approached me like, yo, we really want to work with you, you know, for you to get more traction. We see your videos are doing good and the Jobber song is doing very well, but you need to start gigging more. So they took me and Kila Kao. The plan wasn't actually to be seen as a duo. It's never been the vision. The last thing I wanted for myself is me and Kila Kao to be seen as a team, you know? It's like, okay, rather have a Kamo Mphela and a Kila Kao come together and become, yeah, okay, Kamo and Kila Kao, apart from Kila Kao and this girl, yeah. Or Kila Juo. Yeah, I must have my own identity with whoever I am coming together with. So we started doing the videos, started gigging together, and everything. And people were really going crazy over the combo. It was really inspiring because girls and niggas started coming together, working together. You know when you see videos, kids are tagging you. So, but I later decided to branch out and stand on my own because it's never been my vision to be associated with somebody. And it got to a point where people saw me and Kila as one thing, and that's what I did not want. I didn't want to get lost in Kila. I was identity. That was the last thing. So I had to move. I had to take a risk. I decided to go into music because firstly I like performing, I love dancing, and I thought as a dancer, I've done my research, majority of the dancers don't really make a living out of it or come out of it, because dancers are really underpaid in this industry. So I was like, okay, I need to stay as a dancer. My blueprint needs to be Kamo Mphela the dancer, but I'd rather dance to my own music and make coins from dancing to my own music. And there's power in that, because now I can relate to a whole lot of dancers. When I make music, I know, okay, a dancer would want this in the music, and then all the dancers can enjoy my music apart from just being a dancer. There's so many good dancers in this world. I'm not saying I'm the best, I just really took the opportunity and ran with it, you know. So I was just like, okay, let me do something different. Took my dancing, put the music together, let's see what's gonna happen. Babes was the biggest because she did that. Beyonce's the biggest, Chris Brown is the biggest, Michael Jackson, you know what I'm saying? I gravitate a lot from them. Personally, Michael Jackson and Beyonce, that's where I'm headed. To be honest, it's very challenging because obviously I'm trying out this music thing. I'm not saying I am an artist. I am saying, okay, I can dance. So let me try this artisty thing so it can work for me, you know? And a whole lot of people come at me with judgment, like, she can't make music, dude. I'm not saying I'm making music. I'm saying this is what I stand for. I am going to do this because this is my path, you know? So it's really tricky because a whole lot of people have a lot of comments, but that really doesn't distract me because I know the vision, and people always change, you know? Like, you'll be moving and then people now see that, okay, it's working, now they want to compliment you. So it's just like, okay, if I'm going to listen to you, then I'm going to be a stop sign, you know? So working with a whole lot of artists is very tricky, and it's very hard to get people that are gonna be with you and stand by you because of what you have to offer. Everybody's just after the hype, and I've been getting a whole lot of people coming at me because of hype. So I'm just really trying to ground myself. I don't want to blow with the wind, like I'm just going there, you know. You're all over the place. I don't want to be all over the place. So I choose who I work with. It needs to be an energy thing. It needs to be something that I have envisioned. Independence, I was going through a whole lot of challenges because I just didn't know what to do. You know, you're just going and you don't know what's happening, but you're believing in what you're doing. So I went from that, and I am really grateful for joining Major League because I even let them know I don't want to be under Major League. I don't want to be seen as an artist under Major League. I wanted to be Kamo Mphela and Major League working together. Don't take me as an understudy. Don't take me as somebody who you have to do things for me, you know? And joining them, I started doing stuff for myself. I took ownership of everything that I do, from booking a bus to whatever I want to do, if I want to do something, you know? My previous management was very supportive in a sense. They were really good, but for me, they just babied me a lot, and I want to stand on my own one day, so I don't want to be babied, because they handled everything from contracts to everything that I do. So I didn't have a voice then, but I joined Major League and I was just like, guys, this is what I want. If you guys can't offer me this, then I can't be a part of y'all, you know? And they were like, no, fully, it's fine. I was just like, dude, all I'm asking for is guidance. I'm not asking to be babied. I'm not asking that you guys do everything for me. Show me the ropes. How do I stay 10 years in the industry? How do I do stuff so I can teach other people as well, you know? So joining them helped me. I got my dances. I got everything that I've always envisioned. I started touring. I got my dances when? Late November, after my birthday. So I recruited my dancers. My dancers, note by, these aren't just random people. These are people I used to dance with in high school. People that I schooled with in high school. So we used to open circles all together, so we know where we all come from. Because I was just like, okay, I'm getting dancers. I want to grow my team. I need a DJ. I need a driver. You know, I need to get a bus. So how do I go about it? Do I pick people that just want to work with me off the hype? And when I don't have money, they run? Or do I get people who know that I don't have anything to offer, but they see the vision? You know, where it's just like, okay, Kamo, we know you don't have money, but we are moving because we believe in the vision, you know? So I started getting those type of people. Tlochi and Kabelo, those are my two dancers. I got my driver, Tato. I got my DJ. So it got to a point where I made, actually, my DJ as my driver. So Tato is a DJ and a driver. And then my two dancers are also road managers. So in this team, we're all doing everything. I can even road manage, you know, pick up the phone and talk to somebody. How I got the idea of many men. I had just made a drastic move in my career, a drastic decision. So I just felt like a whole lot of people that used to be in my corner just switched on me. A whole lot of people switched up. A whole lot of people were judging my decisions, not understanding why I took this leap of faith, you know? So I was just like, okay, these people were supporting me. All of a sudden now I'm switching up. They don't really understand where I'm headed, but they acting like, okay, no, she's gonna flack out, she's gonna fall, you know? So I was just like, okay, these people, that's where it came from. Like, actually, I see you guys. You know, you guys are actually not the ones. Fill Up was my first biggest career milestone, and I haven't been in the industry for a year. I actually made a year like 2 days ago, but anyway, I hadn't been in the industry for a year, and I'm performing at Fill Up. It's always been, that was my first time actually at Fill Up in my whole life. And my first time was like on the stage. So I was just like, okay, cool, we're actually moving, you know? There's certain people who spend years trying to be on that stage like that, and then I just did it in a couple of months, you know? That was very inspiring. The second one was Ultra. Like, Ultra was like, yo, dog, international. You know, when you see the vision, like, we are headed in the right direction. I see you, you know? Ultra was like my second biggest one, where I was just like, dude, I see you, you know? Because I want to perform international. I need to leave, you know? That's my whole vision. So Ultra was like, okay, we are coming. And then Santon really contributed to my career in a sense of I took my performances very seriously, to the point where, okay, I need to make sure that I kill my performances. I need to make sure that I'm dressed nicely. I need to make sure that I present myself very perfectly, you know, because I had dropped the EP 20 when it happened, but that EP, I wasn't really like confident about it. And the same way I wasn't really confident about Santon after we did the whole Santon song, you know, up until people were like, actually, the song is dope. And I was like, okay, cool. So Santon really put me in a position that I was like, okay, apart from me just performing, when I perform, I want people to clap or cry. So it's either one, like it must always happen. And then I worked more on it, you know, and it put me in a position where every time I performed, people always clap. Like every time, I can't just go off stage and then people are like, oh, okay, cool. Like it's cool. Like, okay, sharp. You know, people were like crying. Some people were clapping. I was like, okay, cool. So this inspires me to work more on my craft. I feel like the twins have Bandile and Banele, the major league DJs. So in a way, they have contributed to me being where I am, in a sense of, okay, you need to stop looking a certain way. You need to, if you want to sell something, look a certain way. If you want to attract certain brands, you know, present yourself. You can't just be like, look like any other girl. You know, girl next door, like, oh, okay, cool. And then in a sense of confidence-wise and empowering, Busiswa has really helped me. Like, she was just like, girl, come on. You're like a gone girl, so you need to boss up. Stop being scared, stop being afraid. You know, sometimes I see that you doubt yourself, so you need to take control, take full charge, stand alone, especially because you're young, so you have more power, you know, because you're younger and you have more of an advantage, like a 10, 15-year advantage ahead of everybody else. I'm on Empower. I'm working with Empower, Mr. Easy. Mr. Easy's label, they're like an international platform that put your music on an international basis, that opens doors for you to actually be an international artist. I'm working on an EP. I'm working on so many things. I am going to open a dance studio. I am working on dropping a Kamo Mphela dancing toy. I'm working on a whole lot of stuff. So yeah, do look out. I am coming. My words of inspiration is, don't ever give people too much power over what you do. Don't ever doubt yourself. So just work on whatever you want to do. You know, give yourself time. Never doubt yourself. Believe in your vision. You're the only person who can push yourself to the fullest. Yo, what's good, people? Kamo Mphela here. That was Weekend Turn Up. Shout out to Sportine and Adidas. Hopefully you guys got some words of inspiration. Ooh,